So right. Good morning, students. Welcome to the class. So today, let us see another problem of cycloidal curves. So first of all, let us read the problem carefully. What is the given data? So see here, a circle of diameter 60 mm. So given data is the diameter of the circle is 60 mm. Is rolling on the ground. So you have to notify this is the ground. Okay. Next, for one complete revolution without any slip. Okay. Draw the curve and name it. So you have to draw the curve and you have to name the curve. What is it? Next, draw the tangent and normal at a point M. This is M. Which is 70 mm away from the center of the rolling circle. So here what is the rolling circle? This is the rolling circle. So you have to locate such a point M which is at a distance of 70 mm from the center of the rolling circle. Right? So now let us see the constructional procedure of the cycloid. So now here what is there? We have 60 mm of diameter is there. So normally you have to draw a curve with the radius or a circle with the radius of 30 mm as radius, because the diameter is 60. You take 30 mm as radius, then next draw a circle. So after drawing a circle, just divide into 4 equal parts. First just divide into 4 equal parts. After dividing the 4 equal parts, take the bottommost point of the circle as point P. Then divide the circle into 4 equal parts. Would mark the center point as C. Then next point P is there. And first you have to find out the length of the ground. So let us say this is nothing but ground. I can say this ground is nothing but a plane surface or a flat surface. You can imagine it is a table or it is a ground, or it may be a road, or in any manner. The question may be given in any manner. So you have to understand that ground is nothing but a plane surface. That is a straight surface. Okay. Let us go. How much is the distance between P and P dash? So how to calculate? So the distance of P, P dash, is equal to nothing but the circumference of the circle. How you should calculate the circumference of the circle? The circumference of the circle is given as pi d. Okay. So here the value is pi d. You know the value of pi? What is the value of pi? This is 3.14 into, what is the value here? 60 mm. So this is 60. Okay. So calculate it. 3.14 into 60 mm. So you will get some value here in terms of mm. Okay, let us take the 180 mm. So 180 or 1985 like that. Okay. So draw a line here. Just put the arrowheads as a dimensional line. Okay. And put the value of pi d here. Okay, this is the pi d. Nothing but the distance from point P to the circumference. Once again, P is nothing but the distance of P, P dash. P, P dash is nothing but the length of the circumference of the circle. Right. After drawing this circle, okay, after drawing this P, P dash line and mentioning the value, circumference value, next, divide the circle into 8 equal parts. 8 equal parts or 12 equal parts or maybe 12, 16, like that. So if you make more number of equal parts, then it is very easy and convenient to draw a smooth curve. Right. So now I will divide this circle into 8 equal parts. So you know how to bisect an angle. So first you bisect an angle, any one of the sides, this side or this side. So how to construct a bisect an angle? So take any convenient radius, draw an arc. After that, then the same radius, you make two arcs from this point as a center and this point as a center. Next, you draw a line passing through this point of intersection and center point, you will make this one line.
Okay.
After getting this line,
simply you take with the help of a drafter,
simply you draw a perpendicular line to this one. Okay. So now you draw a perpendicular line to this line such that the circle is divided into 8 equal parts. So name this one. So now this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, 6, 7.
So here, if you see,
or if you draw a straight line,
if you draw a straight line,
1 and 7 should pass on the same line. 1 and 7 should pass on the same line. Next, 2 and 6 is on the same line as well. 3 and 5 will be on the same line. And 4th one is the topmost line. So now what you have to do is draw the parallel lines from 1, 7, 2, 6, 3, 5 and 4. Just simply watch. So now I am drawing a parallel lines from 1 and 7. Next, 2 and 6. Next, 4 and 3. Next, 4. Sorry, this is 3 and 5. Now what I will do is, I will draw a perpendicular line from this point. Now this is a complete box or the area of the cycloid. Out of this box, we will not get the curve, only within this box. So all these lines will be very lightly. So I think you may not be visible or you can see it clear. Then next, what to do is, already divided the line, parallel lines. Then next, this is the point P and this is the center point C. Where is the center point C of the rolling circle? It is exactly above the P. Okay, you have to create the center points on this center line. 2, 6 and center lies on the same line. So before going to that, what to do is, you have to divide the line P, P dash into how many equal parts? So whatever the equal number of divisions that you have made in the circle, that number should be made equal parts. You know how to divide a line into equal parts? How many? 8. So 8 equal parts. By line division method, you divide this P, P dash into 8 equal parts. So now directly I am not doing this line division method, directly I will go for this one. So this is 1. Two, three, four, five, six. This is 7, and that one is last point is 8. Okay. Now P is the point which has a center above, that is C. And if I move this circle in clockwise direction, I move this circle in clockwise direction such that 1 comes in contact with a 1 on the ground. One first equal part on the circle comes in contact on the ground. Similarly, when I move once again, this 2 on the circle comes and touches the ground 2 point. Similarly, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So now, with respect to the particular point 1, when it touches 1 on the ground, where will be the center? Where will be the center? The center will be exactly above the first point because when P is in contact with the ground, then C is above the P. Such that if 1 is in contact with 1, here we will get C1 above. When 2 is in contact with 2, 2 will be center, C2 will be above this one. So right, now I will draw a perpendicular lines from the respective points on the ground. Can see clearly I am drawing the perpendicular lines to P, P dash, P, P dash with the respective points up to the center line. So this is 2, C and 6th line. Now I will write this one as C1, C2, C3,
C4, that is center 4, center 5, center 6, center 7, and this is center 8. So now after locating the C1, C2, C3, C4 and C5, all these things, next, what is the next procedure? Now you have to draw the arcs from the respective centers when the circle is moving in clockwise direction, right? So now P is here, the point P is here on the circumference of the circle. Now when one rotation and one part of the rotation comes, this one will contact this one and center will be there. And where is the position of point P? So ultimately the point P position will be moved in such a way that this locus of this point P is moved to the 1-7 line. So where it will be? Now we will see where does the locus of this point P which moves with the respective points on the line. So here let us go for a construction procedure. Take PC as a radius. PC, what is the PC radius? PC is nothing but the radius of that circle, that is diameter is 60, so radius is 30 mm. So take 30 mm as a radius. C1 as the center, make an arc on the first line. So this is first and seventh line. Okay, so C1 as the center, make an arc on the first line. C2 as the center, make an arc on the second line. Next, C3 as the center, make an arc on the third line. Okay, so it is here, third line. C4 as the center, it will be exactly because we have 8 points, on the circle. So fourth point is the top, so we will get from the top of the circle, so here we will get an arc. Then next, after getting the arc, it will move towards right. So C5 as the center, it is an arc. Okay. C6 as the center, we will get another arc here. C7 as the center, we will get an arc. And C8 as the center, you will get an arc here. Okay. So, after getting all the arcs, that is respective arcs with the respective centers, name this as P1, this is P2, this arc is P3, this one is P4, this one is P5, this one is P6, this one is P7, and this one is P'. Okay, now after getting P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 up to P', draw a smooth hand curve. Draw a smooth hand curve passing through all these points. These points are nothing but the locus points of the P with respect to the equal divisions on the circumference of the circle. So now see clearly how I am drawing.